morning to the sixth grade production of Shakespeare's A Midsummer Night's Dream. Enjoy the show.
Take Try my hand. There's a marvelous, convenient place for rehearsal. The screen plots will be your stage.
Peter Prince?
What bottom?
The thing with this comedy that will never replace. We must write a prologue to say that we do not harm with our swords.
Will not the ladies be afraid of a lion? We must tell that he is not really a lion.
We must have moonlight in the chamber. I have another thing. We must have a wall. For here is this we big talk to the wall.
Some man or other must represent wall.
Let him and house cards have a swagger in here. I'll be a listener to the play, and perhaps by some cause, I may be an actor too.
Oh, my dearest Disby, stay here, and by and by I go to the appear.
The fairies know that they can have fun with mere mortals. Pike decides to play a joke on Bob.
Thank you. stars and flock to these dusty realms so straight that will not move each other's way. Use this herb to charm the sanders of eyes, all of this will seem but a journey.
While Puck has been enjoying the spectacle to quarreling lovers, Oberon regrets the mistake and has also become more concerned with his own problems. While Puck leads Demetrius and Lysander around in circles of the woods, Oberon intends to go back to his queen. He would let her recharge her feet in the hole and then take the spell off her so that she no longer loves Bottom in his donkey head. Puck warns Oberon that night is soon over, so they both better be quick.
Up and down, lean down, I believe that up and down.
Where art thou proud to be here? Speak.
Here, villain, tell the truth.
I will be constrained.
Follow me down to play the world.
Why, Sanders, speak again. Where are you?
Thou coward, and wilt thou not come? I'll whip thee with a rod.
He goes before me and still lives in the arms. When I come where he is called, then he is gone. For I have fallen in a dark and uneven way, and here I will rest until gentlemen.
Ha ha ha! Why comest thou not?
Nathan, you mock me, but I am faint. I will measure my length on this cold bed, but wait till daylight.
Oh, weary night, oh, long and tedious night. Sleep that sometimes shuts up sorrow's eyes, stealing a while from minor company.
Let but three come one more. Two of both kinds makes up four.
Here are the rest of the break of day. Heaven to the bystander when you pray.
When thou wakest, thou takest the light in the sight of thy former liaison. Jack shall have Jill, naught shall go ill, and all shall be well. Speak of Aegeus, is this not the day for new shaking the
Demetrius, that would have defeated you and me.
My good lord, I know not how Howard is, but my love for her may as well melted as the snow. The object and pleasure to mine eye is only how enough.
Fair love is unfortunately the man of all this will hear more again by and by with us. This couple shall be with, away with us to Athens. We'll hold in peace, come on.
Are you sure we are awake? Let's follow.
Thank you.
And then that same December, they would have done a Christmas play in third grade, and unfortunately, we were still social distancing, and they didn't get that opportunity either. So this was their first official play and performance as sixth graders, and I'm so proud of them. Let's give them another round of applause. So thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Tate, for that vision and for making all of this happen.